Hello, this is Mocha Product Manager Martin Brennand with a quick tutorial on removing logos in Avid Media Composer 2019. So we'll be working with this footage today where we need to remove the logo from the backpack. We could just blur or replace the logo, but we want to remove it completely. Typically, this kind of workflow is done in other compositing packages, but using Mocha's fast and accurate planar tracking and the Mocha Remove module, we can get rid of this detail into Media Composer cleanly. Avid also introduced flute support into Media Composer 2019. We support this color depth in the Mocha Pro 2019.5 AVX plugin, and we'll use it here. Keep in mind, however, that higher bit depth does introduce some other limitations, which we'll get to later. So we'll start by dragging the Mocha Pro effect onto the footage track. We can then open Mocha Pro by clicking on the option at the top of the effect controls. Note that when you first load up Mocha, you may be in the Essentials layout, but for this tutorial, we're going to switch to the Classic mode because we need to use it for the Remove module. So keep that in mind when you first load up Mocha. Inside Mocha Pro, you can see that it's using the full 32-bit float from the Avid timeline. We're going to start by drawing a tracking shape around the logo and bag. We'll do this by selecting the X-Spline tool from the toolbar and setting down some points. You can see here I'm not limiting it just to the logo area. Since Mocha is a planar tracker, we want to get as much texture detail as possible. I'm also trying to avoid these moving straps. Otherwise, we would need to roto out these on another layer in order to be ignored by the track. Mocha's planar tracker is often good at ignoring these details that get in the way, but it's good practice to try and avoid them in the first place. We'll now turn on the surface and grid to help visualize the track. I'm lining up the blue surface here to the logo so it's clear how the plane is moving over time. I'm also going to use the perspective planar tracking, as there's a bit of swing in the bag movement, so the logo distorts a fair bit. I'm also going to turn on quick stabilize in the view controls so the footage stays locked to the track area. This makes it easier to see the tracking accuracy up close without having to move the viewing canvas around. With everything set, then we can just start tracking forwards. Now, we can either monitor the track as it progresses to make sure everything is fine, or do what most people do during a track and go to the bathroom. Once the track is done, we can scrub through the shot to make sure it's locked down well. At this point, we could use Mocha's insert tools to insert a different logo instead, but instead what we want to do is remove the logo completely. To do this, we're going to use the Remove module. We'll start by renaming the track something obvious, such as Bag Track, and then switch off the visibility of the layer so we don't have to see it for the next stage. We'll then draw a new layer fairly tightly around the logo patch to be our remove shape, because at minimum, the remove module requires at least two layers, a tracked background layer and a foreground remove layer. We'll also rename this layer to keep things clear, and then under the link to track dropdown, we will choose the original track layer to make the new layer move in the same way. Scrubbing through the shot again, we can check to make sure the shape is following around the logo patch tightly, as well as checking for those pesky bag straps interfering. One strap is a little close for comfort, so I'll adjust the shape a bit tighter to be sure. Now we can switch to the remove module. Because the logo is not moving over any form of parallax background, we're going to have to paint a clean plate. Typically, the remove module is used to remove objects moving over a background, such as here, where we're removing a skater in the foreground. For the logo, it's directly on the bag, so there's no visible background behind it. Let's try doing a render immediately to illustrate this. As you can see, nothing was removed, because Mocha cannot see any frames over time that could use the background to replace it. To get around this, instead we're going to go back to our input clip and click the Create button. This lets us save a 32-bit float clean plate TIFF file. We'll name this something appropriate and switch over to Photoshop to clean it up. One thing you'll notice coming into Photoshop is the plate is a bit lighter. This is because the color space used in Avid and Mocha is different to what Photoshop is reading. This won't cause any problems back in the render, so we can edit on the clean plate regardless. If you feel more comfortable seeing the more natural darker plate, try switching over to monitor RGB for a more display-friendly image to work with. You'll also note that we can't use the patch tool. This is because 32-bit float is not supported for this tool, and we'll have to resort to the old favourite, the clone stamp tool. I've sped up the recording here so you don't have to watch the entire paintwork, but the general process is just picking like areas in the shot with the clone stamp tool, then paint out the logo completely to match the bag texture. We can then save the TIFF file again and move back to Mocha. Inside Mocha, the plate will automatically be updated. You can check this by going to the clean plate clip on the same frame you created it. We then need to choose Use Clean Plates exclusively to use our paint job through the rest of the shot. I'll also turn on linear illumination to relight the plate throughout the track shot. Illumination is necessary when there's movement in the shot because light will change over time. I'll also turn on auto step to jump over frames that don't need referencing. We'll then turn off overlays so we can see the render a bit clearer and start rendering forwards. Now you can see the clean plate is being used for every frame and being relit accordingly as the bag moves. Once we're happy with how the render is looking in Mocha, we can then close and save and go back to the Media Composer timeline. Then all we need to do is go to the module section of the Mocha Effect Editor interface, choose Remove from the list, and click Render. As we scrub through the shot, you can see it quickly updates the render to remove the logo. It's much faster to render than a normal remove, as the render only needs to reference that one frame of the clip to clean up the shot. You can do this with as many frames as you like. So that's a quick tutorial on removing logos inside Media Composer 2019 with Mocha Pro. Mocha Pro's AVX plugin is of course not limited to tracking and object removal. There are many additional features like clip inserts, stabilization, masking, and other advanced tools directly rendering onto the Media Composer timeline. If you have any questions, as always, let us know in the comments or post on the forums over at borisfx.com.